risk of infectious contact. Flooded district for treatment and rehabilitation.
Should I clear space for Samuel then?
If you like, but he won't use it.
Why?
He can't sleep in regular beds anymore, or that's what he says. Says he was in the Navy too long. Can you believe it?
Oh.
That pile of wood out there? It's a hovel he built from an old rowboat.
Well, let's get down to it. First off, I know that assassination is dark business, but sometimes good men have to do bad things to make the world right. Our purpose is clear. We want to restore Her Majesty's line by finding and putting Emily Caldwin on the throne. To those ends, we'll hide, act in shadow, take them apart, piece by piece. Tonight, High Overseer Campbell dies by your hand. It won't be easy. He's protected by his overseers, an army of religious zealots. But if anyone can do it, you can. Your exploits are legendary. Campbell carries a private journal. Once you've eliminated him, get the journal, because we think it contains Emily's location. Recovering her is obviously critical, assuming she's alive. That's the gist of it. Remember our cause and strike true. We're counting on you. Another thing. Campbell is holding a former overseer by the name of Martin. He's one of us, and if you manage to find him, give him whatever help you can. He's a master strategist, and he got caught working for our cause. It'd be good to have him back here at the Hound Pits.
Oh, Corvo? If you've a moment. Corvo. Hello. I'm Callista. I work here for Admiral Havelock. I'm sorry to intrude on your business, but this is important. I suspect you're going to kill the High Overseer. That wretched man. There's really no reason for you to listen to me. But my uncle, Jeff Kernow, still serves as captain in the City Watch. But he's a good man, and my only family. The chatter in servant circles is that Campbell just took delivery of an exotic poison, and I think I know why. My uncle's not corruptible like the rest of them. Campbell is going to poison my uncle. Do you think you could protect him? You used to do that, right? Before you had your current profession. Before you became an assassin.
Thank you. Ready to go? Just give the signal. It'll be a rough trip. Used to be you'd go straight up Clavering Boulevard, but now it's not so easy. Half the city's dead of the plague. The other half's fighting over what's left. City Watch still holds the bigger streets, and they've set up those wall of light checkpoints. A man walks through one of those, and he ends up burned to a crisp. Everything not controlled by the City Watch is gang territory. There are the real odd birds living on the fringes, like that granny Rags. They say she's nuts. I don't know which is worse. Just take your pick.
Easy, damn it. In the boat. Canal's got enough shit in it as it is.
Did I tell you about the time I almost caught that guy and killed the Empress?
The city's dead. We'll make it 3 more months. Pass me by. All the others.
Please. I'm a bit shaken right now. I saw some terrible things today.
Jack, you'll share your food with me tonight?
Attention, Dunwall citizens. This is a special announcement from our honorable Lord Regent.
This is the Lord Regent speaking. It is with regret that I announce that my term as Lord Regent has been extended through the month of harvest and potentially beyond. In addition, in this continuing crisis, the overseers of the Abbey of the Everyman remain in service to the state and are empowered to enforce order whenever and wherever necessary. We owe our thanks to High Overseer Campbell for the generous loan of their services.
Oh no, that's not a knife. Thanks. Yes, I would, indeed. I told you the knives go off. Dear? Is that you, my dear husband? My eyes aren't what they used to be. Have you seen my little birdies? Oh, the dear things must be starving without their granny. Here, birdies. Here. Oh, my. I think I have gentlemen callers again, but not the way I used to, not the nice ones. I hear them, and they're not very polite ones either. Granny Rags, Granny Rags, let us in. Ah, well, they'll go away again if they know what's good for them. But what a bother. Use the key to the front door, love. You'll see to those ruffians, won't you? I think the little birdies are sad today. Granny, Granny, come out with me instead. Granny, Granny, Granny.
Be careful, Corvo. They call her Granny Rags. You wouldn't recognize her real name, or even the name of her family. But an emperor begged for her hand once, and rich young men fought each other for her favor. I watched her consider them all, measure their worth, and find them wanting. Then, she made a different choice. You're on your way to face the High Overseer, the leader of a great cult dedicated to loathing me. What will you do, I wonder?
I told you the knives go on the left. They've always gone on the left. You never li-
Let us in, Granny! Who's the-
I think the little birdies are sad. Oh, my dear. I knew you'd help me with those ill-mannered boys. My brave man. Listen, Granny has a birthday present for you. I got it from the outsider, and now I'm giving it to you. Go on. It's upstairs. On the vanity. I think you'll cut a nice figure with it. Remember how we used to dance? Our parties were even grander than those at the Boyle Manor. Everyone wanted to come. If I was a birdie, I'd want to eat that.
Yes, I would.
I hope you like the little gift I got for you. It's the least I could do for turning those louts away. I can't bear these Bottle Street children. Ruffians, every last one of them. Rotten apples. And that slack jaw is the worst of the lot. You know what I just thought of? You could do something else for me. Another little favor. And I'd give you another present. Another lovely rune carved from the bones of a dead whale. Do you remember my doctor, dear? Dr. Galvani? Now there was a clever man. He's got all sorts of nasty rat guts and disease in his laboratory. Wouldn't it be a shame if some of that mess found its way into the Bottle Street gang's elixir still? That'd teach him. See to it, dear. I'll find you another present just like the first. Galvani lives on Clavering Boulevard, or at least he used to. Those were the days. Now run off. My baby birdies are hungry. So precious. But they're shy. You'll have to go, or they won't come.
I owe you, brother. I won't ask about the mask. I wouldn't want my face seen either, pulling a stunt like that. You know what? I'll return the favor. Come by Griff's shop. That's my business. Well, it was, at one time. But now I'm reduced to scavenging things from here and there as the city dies. If you need anything, I wouldn't mind trading for a little money. Maybe someday the plague will blow over and everything will go back to normal. But until then, it's scavenging for me. Huh?
watching how they operate.
So
City Watch owns these streets. That's not gonna change. You should bathe. I can smell you from here.
Another night, another patrol with you.
The door handle to Dr. Galvani's lab?
Yeah, I think so.
Then you have to scrub. The rats get their vital essence. The doctor said.
Vital essences? Does that mean guts? I heard you got eaten alive at cards. Bug someone else.
Now, no stupid goddamn. That one somehow.
Can't stay hidden forever. Someone help me out! Bastard!
Chance you'll share your food with me tonight?
Please, not now.
Touched by the outsider, he is given dark powers. He can slip and float across the world.
Well, that give him a leg up for sure.
It's no coincidence that most men won't even whisper his name.
Is it true that he lives in the flooded district with them weepers and wild hounds?
That's what they say. Perfect place for a paid killer to hide.
You got lucky. When you're this handsome, you don't need luck.
Face like a hagfish.
Pay up. Don't be sour.
Say, when's Slapjaw coming down?
Not till the next batch of millennials.
You wanna check on me?
Then you better get all your shit together, huh?
Everything's fine. I'm still on your gun.
So he goes, not to the Abbey or the office of the High Overseer, but one of the other places.
They train the Overseers to be weird.
Crazy.
He just wants to know where his brother's going. He sneaks it. You know Eddie. Brilliant at it when he's sober.
I remember. Brimsley job, hitting the dumbwaiter all night.
Yeah, so he goes from room to room, kids sleeping. An overseer giving a lecture to the kids. A couple guys training with those hounds.
Stuff you expect.
But
some kind of machine.
Then a woman laughing. Laughing and laughing. Then music. Kind of blinky, funky.
Noblemen laid with the scullery maid, so loudly they made quite a riot.
The nobleman's wife took the butcher and knife and carved herself some peace and quiet.
Oh, I get it. The wife done cut them both, right?
Yeah, that's the gist.
About your turn.
Let me think. Okay, yeah, I got one. Ready?
I'm listening.
There once was a sailor from Morley, who paid a fee. He gave her his cash, he gave her a rag, and that's all. There isn't no more.
So.
I knew you wouldn't disappoint me. Now I can stroll along the waterfront in peace. And don't think I've forgotten your little gift. Go on upstairs, dear one.
Attention, watchmen.
This district is now considered a highly infected area. Residents are to be escorted to adjacent neighborhoods, or to
immediate deportation to the flooded district.
Remain in position until qualified personnel have completed the removal of infected bodies.
Them than us. At least some of them had money.
Thank you. help me out! Get around him!
Why can't...
Forget his old ass. I can't even remember the Empress. We tagged it plain. Under Clavering Street is ours. Come on. What's the take?
We got a prowler on the loose.
Plague. Elixir. Bunch of crap. Oh, no stupid goddamn. The fun God damn it.